Hey there, viewers. Did you know that some STDs can cause cancer? Not only that, but one particular cancer-causing STD is incredibly common, and there's a very good chance that you have already been exposed to it at some point in your life. This STD is called HPV, which stands for Human Papillomavirus. More than 43 million people in the United States have HPV. It's the most common STD, and it can lead to genital warts and cancer. So let's learn more about what you can do to protect yourself, even if you've already been exposed. Real quick, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. What is HPV? HPV is a group of more than 200 related viruses. These viruses fall into two categories. The first category is low-risk HPV. Fortunately, most of the low-risk types of HPV aren't harmful. They have no symptoms, and they will go away on their own. However, some low-risk types can cause genital warts. The other category of HPV is high-risk HPV, and the HPV in this subtype can lead to several types of cancer. HPV is spread through sex and intimate skin-to-skin contact. What that means is that HPV can be spread between two people if their genitals touch, even if there's no penetration. What are the symptoms of HPV? Well, most of the time there are no symptoms. Your body's immune system clears the virus and that's that. But sometimes it can present as genital warts, and other times it can present as abnormal cellular changes that then turn into cancer. Genital warts are flesh-colored, soft bumps on the skin that kind of resemble cauliflower. After a person has been exposed to HPV, it will usually take 1 to 3 months for genital warts to appear. Genital warts are often painless and can be removed by a doctor. If left untreated, genital warts can sometimes go away on their own, but they may also stay the same or grow into large clusters. The signs and symptoms of genital warts include flesh-colored brown or pink swollen bumps on the genitals, itching or irritation around the genitals, or bleeding with intercourse. It is important to note that even if you have genital warts removed, you can still infect another person with HPV and genital warts. Although it can be emotionally upsetting to develop genital warts, they're not actually dangerous, and they don't lead to cancer. There's no test available that can tell you if you have HPV, and unfortunately, the high-risk types of HPV, meaning the types that cause cancer, won't develop into any physical symptoms that you can see or feel. The only way to prevent them from turning into cancer is to get regular pap smears with your gynecologist. Cancer often takes years, even decades, to develop after exposure to HPV. So regular screening for cervical cancer can be life-saving and can help you find signs of a problem before cancer develops. A pap smear is a fairly painless procedure where a healthcare provider will swipe a little brush across the cervix to collect a sample of cells to see if they're abnormal. If the cells look abnormal, your doctor can perform further tests to see what's going on and potentially prevent you from developing cervical cancer. HPV is best known for causing cervical cancer in women, but it can also cause various types of cancer in men. Other types of cancer caused by HPV are penile cancer, anal cancer, and cancer of the mouth and throat. Unfortunately, there's no cure for HPV. But there are things you can do to protect yourself from getting infected. First, you can get the HPV vaccine, which will protect you from getting the most common types of HPV that lead to genital warts and cancer. The HPV vaccine is safe and effective and can prevent more than 90% of cancers caused by HPV from ever developing. The CDC recommends that all boys and girls receive the HPV vaccine around age 11 or 12. However, the vaccine can safely be given as early as age 9. The vaccine is given in 2 doses, 6 to 12 months apart. However, teens who get the HPV vaccine after the age of 15 will need 3 doses of the vaccine. The vaccine is most effective when it's given before exposure to the virus. This is why it's recommended in adolescents earlier rather than later. The other thing you can do is wear condoms. Condoms don't cover your entire genitals, so they won't necessarily offer you total protection, but they will help lower your chances of getting infected. Condoms will also help protect you against other STDs, such as chlamydia, gonorrhea, and HIV. Here's the good news. Most people who get exposed to HPV have no symptoms at all, and most HPV infections will actually go away on their own within 2 years of exposure. But since we now know that HPV can cause not only genital warts, but also cancer, it's important to do everything possible to protect yourself from acquiring HPV. Have you had an experience with HPV or with one of the HPV cancers? Share your experience with us in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. To learn more interesting facts about the human body, subscribe to the channel. Here are two more videos that you should check out to learn more about your health.